So, Rahu in the fourth house. What does it mean and what does it do? Let's get started with it. So, when Rahu comes into the fourth house, the north node of the moon, well, what is fourth house? Fourth house is happiness, pretty much. It's conveniency, as in having a home, having a nice car. It represents your mother's nourishment. It represents real estate, land. Okay. Then Rahu, what does Rahu represent? Rahu represents taboo breaking. It represents an obsession in person's life. Okay. It represents desires that haven't been fulfilled in the past life and you're here to fulfill them. It represents things that Rahu puts in front of you as an illusion, as a smoke, and you have to break out of it and take another leap forward. Okay. So, and also for and fourth house, as I mentioned, is also a representation of your mother's relationship, your relationship with the mother. So when Rahu comes into the fourth house, it makes a person an extreme patriot of their land. Meaning whatever wherever they are, they want to be the leader there. They want to be recognized as the person who's so patriotic that that everybody should respect them. Because Rahu wants that. It wants that quick respect. It wants to own everything quickly, especially concerning the house that he sits in. So this person wants to conquer the prestige and the honor of the land that they reside in. This person, can also be known as somebody who was raised by a foreign mother. What do I mean by that? Somebody who could have had a stepmother, or somebody, who might have gone through foster care. So he had different parents. And since Rahu represents foreign things, what this does, it makes a person move around a lot in their life. Like they might be going from one school to the other, one home to the other, or it can take the person to a foreign land. Because Rahu aspects the 12th house of foreign travel, foreign settlements. And what happens is they might not be welcome in their own home because they're so, because they're so agile about being the leader of their land. And this can not only give obsession about being patriotic, but it can give obsession about real estate, owning lands, because Rahu wants everything now. So they want to acquire the biggest land. And if Rahu doesn't get it the way it wants to, it might do it illegal ways. Like it might try to change, convince their parents to change the will. They might do something in the title that can give them more land. Okay, so, and obviously this person can make a very good real estate agent because of the fact they're so passionate about owning land. So if somebody comes to them, hey, I want to own a land, they're like, hey, I know the way. Let's go, let's own a land. So it can show somebody who's a real estate builder. Okay. Even presidents or political figures are seen from the fourth house placements. Why? Because fourth house represents your homeland. Okay, not just your home, but your homeland. And so in order to become that Ra who wants to be the most patriotic person who leads the people, into a next leap forward, who does this? A president does this. However, when Rahu is in the fourth house, Ketu is in the 10th house. And 10th house is where Ketu feels like Ketu does not want to take responsibility as much to of a leadership role. Because in order to be a politician, it requires a leader. But if it the only way this happens is if Saturn aspects Rahu aspects Ketu, or if Jupiter or not Jupiter but Sun or Mars are aspecting Ketu because these three planets have that leadership quality. Okay, so only then. But we'll get to when we do Ketu in houses, you'll understand what I'm talking about. In fourth house, it may disturb concentration in school of for a person. Like they may not be too. They might have that, quick mind. I want to be here. I want to be here. I want to be here. It kind of produces like a ADD personality. Like this person just cannot sit at one place and concentrate because Rahu is about the foreign things, foreign, the taboo breaking. So they cannot sit through a proper prepared lecture. They want to know something more than what they're being taught. They want to know about some worldly thing. So this also obviously represents settlement in the foreign lands because Rahu aspects the fifth and the ninth plate from itself. So from the fourth house, it aspects the 12th house of foreign settlements, of even jail and hospitals and asylums. So obviously, you can create some mishap in your homeland that might have either extradited you to a foreign country, or you might have something might have happened in your homeland that you now had to move to a foreign country to escape something. Okay, the eighth house is what? Occult, sudden changes. Eighth house represents things hidden in the deep, occult, joint assets. Okay, so Rahu obviously creates an interest in the occult science and the underground knowledge, but also if Rahu is, you know, not well placed, it's in an enemy sign. What it does is that this person might try to swindle their spouse, whether it's husband or wife, into taking their assets. Okay, this doesn't necessarily happen that, you know, this person will do that. But, you know, if Rahu is really receiving a negative aspect with Saturn or Mars here, what it can do is just, yeah, this person wants to achieve everything. So whatever its aspects, it wants to achieve. So when Rahu is aspecting joint assets, it really will look for owning all the assets with their husband or wife. But pretty much anywhere Rahu goes, it wants to be recognized for the things that it's representing. So it can represent somebody who was so patriot, who so wanted it, their country or their land, you know, to respect them, that people may not actually respect them. And either, you know, they are killed, assassinated for, you know, being in that environment of a leadership, or they have to kind of run away from their land in order to, you know, escape these taboo breakings that they provided in their land. So guys, this is my analysis on Rahu in the fourth house. If you're new to my channel, subscribe above and check out my videos every day. Otherwise, if you want to know more about astrology, check out my link below. Check out my book, The Astrology at the Speed of Light, and my articles. Otherwise, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.